Hello, welcome to netvn channel. How easy it is to share files through web browsers. Because web browsers are available on any computer. So is it difficult to share files like that? The answer is no, you watch this video till the end to know how. First you install IIS for your computer. When installing, don't forget to select WebDAV Publishing and Basic Authentication Features. Here I will guide you step by step from basic to advanced. Thereby you can freely choose how you build your own website. After the installation is done, open IIS and configure it. After installing IIS, you will have a default website and we will use it to create a shared website. You select default website in the left menu and then enable the directory browser. Next you enable WebDAV authoring rules. After enable you create a new rule, here you choose all user. Under permissions you choose read, source, write. For basic needs, you just need to configure IIS like that. Now you create a new folder in the root of the website and copy the data you want to share there. Here I will create a new folder and name it test. Then I will copy some photos to share with everyone. Now let's try accessing it with a web browser to see if it works. As you can see, we have created a sharing site. We can view and download these files. But as you can see, it only works within your local network, so what do you need to do to access this shared site through the internet? We will deal with this in the next steps. First of all, you will set a static IP address for your computer. With port forwarding on the router will require your computer to have a static IP address. In this example, I assigned my computer a static IP address of 10.11.32.99. Depending on your local network IP address range, you assign the IP address accordingly. Next, you will forward port 80 to the static IP address you just set up in the previous step. Specifically, I create a new port forwarding, name it HTTP and will forward it to IP address 10.11.32.99. For your router, the way to forward the port will be different, so you should refer to the manufacturer's homepage for how to do it. After successful port forwarding, you can access your website from anywhere using your public IP address. However, usually we use dynamic public IP address, so we need to fix it with dynamic DNS service. With dynamic DNS we both get a domain name and can update the public IP address dynamically. Here I use DynU, a free dynamic DNS service. I already created a domain name netvn.freeddns.org and I will assign it to my sharing site. To update public IP address you need to install DynU client. After installing the software and entering your account, your public IP address is updated and assigned to your domain name. This way your shared site has a domain name and you don't need to worry about public dynamic IP address anymore. So we have finished the basic steps and have a complete sharing website. But if you want to set a password or encrypt the communication between the user and the website, then watch this video till the end. First of all, set up a password. You create a new password for your Windows account if you don't have one yet. Here my Windows account is N1 and I will set password as 123. In fact, I recommend setting a strong password. Next, you will enable basic authentication for your website. From now on, when accessing the website, you will be asked to enter your username and password. So now only people with an account can access your website. Even so, your website is not encrypted between the user and the web server. As such, important data will be at risk of being stolen. In the next section, we will encrypt these communications. First of all, you need to download the WinAcme tool. This tool will generate certificates to encrypt communications for IIS. After downloading the compressed file of WinAcme, extract it and name the file so it's shorter and more user-friendly. Before using Windows Acme, you need to create a self-signed certificate for your website. After obtaining the self-signed certificate, you assign it to your website. Don't forget to enter your domain name under host name. Since self-signed certificates are not as secure as Let's Encrypt, you need WinAcme. We try to access the website using HTTPS and fail. This error occurs because we have not forwarded port on the router 443. So I create a new forwarding on the router and name it HTTPS. And I forward port 443 to IP address 10.11.32.99. This is the IP address of the computer where my website is located. Thus you can access your website using HTTPS. Now we will encrypt the communication using WinAcme. Don't forget to run Acme with admin rights. With the first setup, you create a new certificate. Acme will automatically find your domain name on IIS to generate a certificate for it. During setup, you will be asked to update your email address. You need to fill in the information to complete. Because the default certificate is only valid for 6 months, Acme will automatically schedule it to renew the certificate. You can check the task scheduler on your computer to know how to renew the certificate for your site. return to your sharing site, you will see a lock icon next to it and your site is secure. If you use it often and don't want to use a web browser, you can use the software WebDAV Client to access the shared file. There are many software to choose from, but I recommend using WinSCP. An easy to use and free software. With WinSCP, you enter your domain name, your account is accessible to your shared website. In addition to downloading files, you can also upload files. But this way you can only upload small files. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to click like and subscribe to the channel.